Welcome to our devotions. This is Pastor Karita Mbagara, the Deputy Bishop of Christ is the Answer Ministries, but also the Senior Pastor at CITAM Woodley. We started reading from the book of Isaiah chapter 40, where we said that we are finding a sure hope in a time of crisis. We found that God wants his people to be comforted, and so he calls the preachers to preach comfort. He says, comfort, comfort ye, my people. He also says that he wants the ground to be leveled, mountains to be lifted, valleys to be brought low. He continues to say that human beings are like grass as far as he is concerned, but he is a mighty God. And we said that God continues to help his people to take comfort from who he is, from his character. And today, I want us to focus on the fact that God is unequaled when it comes to caring for his people. In verse 9 through to 11, we read, "See, the sovereign Lord comes with power, and his arm rules for him. See, his reward is with him, and his recompense accompanies him. He tends his flock like a shepherd. He gathers the lambs in his arms and carries them close to his heart. He gently leads those that are young." I see two things in this passage. God says that I come with power. My arm rules for me. I am not dependent on any other. I am capable to do what I need to do. But beyond his power, because power is not necessarily helpful to the person that is hearing this message, God says that he shepherds his own like a shepherd takes care of his lambs. What he is saying, and he further says that he carries them to his heart. I see God saying that I will take care of you. I will take care of you personally, because what you carry to the heart is something that is critical, important to you. And even a lamb that is put, you know, at the shepherd's heart is a lamb that needs care. And God says he knows we need care and he will care for us. So he balances his power and his gentleness in perfection. And he wants his people to know that that's what he is going to do. You see, in another passage in the book of Isaiah chapter 49, verse 10, he says the following: "They will neither hunger nor thirst, nor will the desert heat or the sun beat them. He who has compassion on them will guide them and lead them beside the springs of water." God is saying that he will lead his people to a place where they are refreshed. In a difficult time, he will ensure that they are not suffering. You see, it is consistent with what is written in the book of Lamentations. In chapter 3, verse 22 and 23, "The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning." Every morning that arises, the mercies of God and his faithfulness is renewed. This morning, God renewed his faithfulness. God renewed his mercies towards us. And what he is telling us, that even when we are going through difficult times, we can count on his nature to take care of his own. I think when you see this power and you see his gentleness, it means that we have to revere him. We have to honor him. We have to lift him up. We have to worship him. We have to give due regard to him. But at the same time, we have to love him. We have to know that we are also loved. We are objects of his love. Such is the word that God has sent us so that we can be comforted and we can go through this difficult period with his grace upon our lives. I want us to pray for us that as we contemplate on this word, we will be encouraged and be able to withstand all the problems that come our way. Shall we pray? Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for your word. It is sharper than a double-edged sword. It is able to meet us at the points of our need. And I believe that, Lord, as we contemplate on it, we will remember that you love us. We will remember that you are able and that, Lord, you are willing. And we are never alone. We never are left to our own designs. And we thank you. We bless you because of what you have promised to us. We ask this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless you until we meet again.